Good morning everybody, welcome to my Canine Clinic channel. Today I am going to explain you an interesting and prevalent disease, at present prevalent disease, parvoviral gastroenteritis. Because now why I am bringing this video is, every day I am getting more than 5 to 10 new cases every day. And it is a very dreadful disease, especially for unvaccinated dogs. It is very dreadful disease, especially pups less than 6 months of age, they are mostly affected, and also adults also sometimes gets affected. So that's why I am bringing this video, because at present it is very prevalent and several dogs are getting affected, and also they are dying. I will explain you all the etiology, means how it comes, etiology, symptoms, treatment, and all other information I would like to give through this video. So kindly see till the end, don't skip away, because you will lose a lot of information if you are a pet lover or a breeder or a pet owner. That's why if you like this video, kindly like it, share it, and subscribe to it if you are seeing the first time my video. And also press the bell icon to get the next video, especially if I put any other new video into the YouTube. And if you have any doubts, kindly write in the comment section, so that I will definitely answer your questions. Then now we will move to the actual video of parvoviral gastroenteritis. This canine parvoviral gastroenteritis is a very dreadful disease. It is caused by CPV or CPV2 virus, and it is highly contagious. It spreads mainly through the contact of a infected feces or urine of a infected dog. Suppose if an infected dog passes urine or motion near your pet, if your pet licks or sniffs it, you will get the infection. It is mainly spread through the contact with feces. Mainly, first it was invented, parvovirus is recorded in 1976 in Europe. Later on it spread throughout the world. In 1978 it was recorded in several places. The mortality rate is nearly 91% in unvaccinated dogs. If the dog is vaccinated, generally the mortality comes down to 50%. And untreated cases can go up to, as I told you, 91%. I want to tell you some other breeds which are very susceptible and dangerous. Those are Rottweilers, Doberman Pinschers, American Stafford Bull Terriers, English Springer Spaniels, Labradors, and German Shepherds. These breeds are highly affected, and these are very dangerous, especially Rottweilers are very dangerous. Please be careful, all the dog owners of Rottweiler puppies, please note down, please listen to my words. Rottweiler puppies, in Rottweilers, this parvoviral gastroenteritis is very dangerous. Please be vaccinated, vaccinate your pets very careful if your pet is a Rottweiler. I will tell you the symptoms one by one, kindly note down. First symptom that everyone noticed is lethargy. That with lethargy means it becomes very dull and depressed. Next one is vomition. Next one is diarrhea. Sometimes it becomes bloody. If it becomes bloody diarrhea, the survival rate will be very less. Next, fetid smell. Motion will be very fetid smell, and weakness, dehydration, hypothermia. Initially fever will be there. Next, after 2 to 3 days, there will be temperature will fast down. It comes down to hypothermia. It comes down to 37-36 centigrade also. And there will be severe depression. Initially fever followed by the hypothermia. And gastrointestinal tract is severely damaged in this case of parvoviral gastroenteritis. As I told you, this diagnosis is mainly done by the ELISA test. And also some SNAP tests have also come down. And recently with INTAS people have brought SNAP tests, but I think these SNAP tests are not very indicative, and they are also not perfect, as I have noticed in my practice. These INTAS people have brought SNAP tests, but they are not very perfect, as I have noticed in diagnosing the parvoviral gastroenteritis. Next, we will go to the treatment section. This treatment is mainly fluid therapy. It has to be done by the qualified veterinarian only. You cannot do your own treatment at your doorstep, like what I have told in case of skin diseases. In skin diseases, you can do treatment basing off on my advice in my videos. But this fluid therapy is, it has to be done by the qualified veterinarian only. You have to give IV fluids every 2 to 3 hours. For that, IV cannula has to be fixed to the wean of the forelimb, that is cephalic wean, and you have to run the salines every 2 to 3 hours. Suppose if vomiting is more, you have to give the BNS. If motion is more, you have to give the Ringer's lactate. Basing on that, 20 to 50 ml per kg body weight fluid has to be run continuously till the dog recovers. And another antibiotic we use is amikacin. We have to give at the rate of 5 to 10 mg per kg body weight. Next, metronidazole, 20 to 30 ml IV head has to be given. Ondansetron, that is antiemetic, pantoprazole, 20 to 30 mg. We have to give regularly every 3 to 4 hours. And one more thing, important thing is, when animal is having severe vomiting, please prevent the animal to take water, especially normal water, which is room temperature water, should not be given to your puppy. That is very important. Please note down. You can, if the animal is very thirsty, you can give the cold chilled water. You can give chilled water, that too very small quantity, 10 to 20 to 30 ml you can give per time. And again, if the animal is not showing any vomiting, you can give again another quantity of 20 to 30 ml after some time. Only chilled water, please note it down. And to save severe case of bloody diarrhea, you can give the blood transfusion also. Blood transfusion can be given at the rate of 50 to 100 ml every time, every day. You can collect the, from mother, you can collect the blood and you can give directly. Through direct syringe also, heparin coated syringes are will be there. You can take the mother's blood directly and give it to the puppy directly. Because mother blood is always compatible. There will not be any problem by giving the mother's blood. You need not match it also. Suppose if your puppy is affected, you can collect the blood from its mother and give it directly through syringe. You can take 20 ml syringe, 50 ml syringes are there. You can just rinse the heparin solution and directly you can give that. No problem, it will be there. Because in just like humans, there are nearly 12 type of blood groups are there. I will tell you in another video about blood transfusion in dogs. In that, there are 12 blood groups. So, first time if you are giving to your puppy, you need not match. If you are giving blood from your mother, from its mother, you can directly transfuse by taking the blood from its mother and directly giving to the puppy. If there is severe bloody diarrhea in case of puppy suffering from parvoviral gastroenteritis. Next one treatment is CanGlobe P. This CanGlobe P is imported product. It is canine globulins, immunoglobulins for parvovirus is there. There will be 5 ml vials you can directly give, but that is a bit costly. It costs around 3000 rupees. And for small German Shepherd puppy or Pomeranian puppy, 5 ml is sufficient. For a heavy sized dog, it requires 10 to 20 ml has to be given. That costs nearly 10 to 12,000. So everybody cannot afford that treatment. So another treatment has come recently, please note it down. It's a ParvoGuard 5 by Indian Immunologicals Limited. This ParvoGuard tablets are very effective. I have used in my practice also. ParvoGuard tablets, you have to give about 2 to 3 tablets per day. And one more important thing is, don't crush the tablet. Just you have to put the tablet in its puppy's mouth and close the mouth of puppy so that it swallows. And this tablet should be given after giving the antiemetic injection of intravenous. Suppose you have just given the antiemetic intravenous injection now, after half an hour or 1 hour you can give this tablet directly into the mouth. Don't crush the tablet. 2 to 3 tablets per day you have to give. After entering the stomach and intestines, this parvovirus tablet, ParvoGuard tablet, will kill the virus in the intestines, which is present in the intestine. It reduces the virus load. Thereby the bloody diarrhea will be controlled. Should be given at the rate of 2 to 3 tablets per day. It is very effective. I have practiced also. And one more important thing is, it should be given only through the mouth. By closing the mouth, it gets swallowed into the intestine. And this works very well. And this should be, and also this is also a bit costly. Each tablet costs around 100 rupees. And one strip of 10 tablets costs around 10 to 1100, I think. But it has worked very well in my practice. So I request all of you to try these tablets. Whenever your doctor is treating the parvoviral enteritis, in your case, you can suggest, sir, this doctor has suggested. You please tell my name also. My name is Dr. Kaspar Reddy, in Canine Clinic YouTube channel. He has prescribed, sir, he has suggested So kindly prescribe this so that we can use this tablet also along with the routine treatment. Don't use only this treatment. Along with the routine treatment of fluid therapy, antibiotics, metronidazole injections, antiemetics, you have to combine this treatment in addition to the routine treatment. It gives very good results and it helps to save your pet in case of severe gastrointestinal bloody diarrhea. And it has worked very well. So I request you to follow this line of treatment. I will give you in the test also. I will give you some of the photos and pictures of this severely affected dogs with parvoil gastritis in this video. Kindly see it and get information. And finally I suggest you in this case of parvoil gastritis, you should follow the strict guidelines for vaccination. Please note it down. You have to first vaccinate your puppy with the puppy DP of Intervet or MSD company at the 6th week, and next vaccine at 9th week, third vaccine that is 12th week. 6th week, 9th week, 12th week. Kindly follow these instructions, follow the vaccination schedule of DHPPA and get your pet save you from this very dreadful disease. In most of the one more thing I want to tell you is through this video is most of the owners, dog owners feel that suppose on July 6th we will be vaccinating the pets with anti-rabies vaccination freely in our government hospital. What they feel is, they feel that we are giving this DHPPA injection also along with this anti-rabies. Please note that only anti-rabies is given on July 6th, and don't think this DHPPA vaccine is not given, because it is a bit costly vaccine, government cannot afford to give you freely. So I request you to get your puppy vaccinated very correctly and very strictly. After deworming your puppy with Vorax or any Zipet tablet at the rate of 1 tablet for 10 kg body weight, and also at the rate of 1 ml for 1 kg body weight. You have to first deworm the puppy, get the vaccine at the rate of age of 6th week, 9th week and 12th week. Then you can prevent the puppy from getting this severe parvoil gastritis. So I request you to follow my instructions and save your pet from this severe bloody gastrointestinal parvoviral gastroenteritis, because it is very prevalent. This disease is very prevalent in the late winter and also early spring. It is very severe. Now it is severely running. This outbreak is severely running throughout in India. Nearly 10,000 cities are there in India. Nearly 3 crores of dogs are also there in India. There is severe outbreak is there. Kindly follow my instructions and save your pet. If you like this video, kindly like it and share it and subscribe it. And if you have any doubts on this parvoviral gastroenteritis, please write in the comment section. Definitely I will give you and give you the answers for your questions and doubts. And also I'll tell you, next video will be on canine distemper, because that is also very dangerous disease in case of pets. So my video will be on canine distemper after this video. Kindly follow it. Thank you very much. Good day.